Okay, do you know what is the IIS?
Yes, in Internet Information Service.
Yes, the full form of the IIS is what? Internet Information Services.
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Yeah.
Internet Information Service or Server. Clear?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, what is the use of IIS, first of all?
Is it to host applications?
Yes, IIS is the web server where we will host the application to publish that into outside of the world. Is called, what is that? IIS. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
I am repeating, what is the IIS? IIS is nothing but Internet Information Service or Server. We will use the IIS to host the application. Where? In IIS.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Simply we can say IIS is the web server where we will host the application to publish that into outside of the world. Is called, what is that? IIS.
IIS.
Okay. Assume mm-hmm. that once you develop the application by using .NET. Okay. Once you uh-huh. develop the application by using .NET. Mm-hmm. Finally, we will host that application.
In IIS?
On IIS. Then only outside of the people will be able to access the site.
Mm-hmm.
Clear, Linda?
Yep.
Yeah. So simply I can say, okay, simply I can say backbone of the SharePoint is what? IIS.
IIS.
Yeah. Why IIS? Why? Because once you develop the application by using .NET, mm-hmm. manually you need to go and deploy it on IIS.
Right.
Okay, once you develop the application by using .NET,
mm-hmm.
okay, manually we need to go to IIS and host the application.
Okay.
Okay, while deploying the application, if something goes wrong, then entire SharePoint, entire .NET application will not be work.
Okay.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, same way, once you develop the application by using Java, finally where we need to host that application? Apache,
Apache. Mm-hmm.
WebLogic or WebSphere.
Mm-hmm.
Got it?
Yep.
If you are coming to the Microsoft technologies, once you develop the application by using .NET or SharePoint, finally we need to host them on IIS. Then outside of the people will be able to access the site.
Okay.
Clear?
Yep.
Yeah. Next, by default, IIS will come along with what?
With the Windows.
Come along with operating system.
System. Mm-hmm.
Okay. There are two types of operating systems. What are they?
What is it? Client side and server side?
Yeah. Client side operating system. Other one is what?
Server side. Side.
Mm-hmm. Operating systems. Okay. In client side, again, we have what? Different types of operating systems. What are they?
Like Windows 7,
Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10. Server mm-hmm. side operating systems are what?
Windows, like Win Server 2008 or?
Yeah, Windows Server 2008 or 2008 R2. Got it.
Okay.
Or Windows Server 2001 or 2012 R2. Okay, mm-hmm. these are what? Server side operating system. Mm-hmm. What is the latest version of the operating system in server side?
Is it 8.5?
No. What is the latest version of the operating systems in server side?
Server side is what? Server 2012 or? I think
yeah,
there's a new one coming out, right?
2012 R2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Purinda?
Yep.
Yeah. Why SharePoint? Why not other technology? We have .NET as well, right? Then why SharePoint? First, very advantage of the SharePoint is when you create one web application in SharePoint, automatically the application would be hosted on IIS.
Yes, okay. Not manual. Okay.
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 So that is the big advantage of the SharePoint.
Uh-huh.
What is the SharePoint? See, when you create one web application in SharePoint, the application automatically will be deployed on IIS.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If we develop the application by using .NET, what we need to do? Manually we need to go to IIS and host that application. While deploying the application, if something goes wrong, then troubleshoot part is big issue in IIS.
Mm-hmm.
Troubleshoot part is big issue in IIS. Got it? If you go for SharePoint, when you create one web application in SharePoint, automatically the application would be hosted on IIS. So deployment part, you no need to take care. Automatically SharePoint will take care. Got it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. This is about background of the what?
IIS. Okay.
Yeah. So that's why I am telling you backbone of the SharePoint is what? IIS.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So by default, IIS will come along with what? Operating system.
Uh-huh.
By default, IIS will come along with what? Operating system. Along with Windows Server 2008, what is the IIS version we will get? IIS 7.0.
7.0.
Okay. Along with Windows Server 2008 R2, what is the IIS version we will get?
7.2, you said?
7.5. Okay. Along with Windows Server 2012?
8.5.
Along with Windows Server 2012 R2?
8.5.
What is the latest version of the IIS in the market?
8.5?
Yeah, 8.5. What is the latest version of the IIS in the market?
8.5.
Yeah, 8.5. Clear?
Okay.
Okay, any doubt?
No.
Yeah, next. Okay, next.
Okay.
Yeah, now tell me, what are the four pillars of the OOPS concepts? You know OOPS concepts, right?
I vaguely know. Is it that encapsulation, abstraction,
yeah,
and all
that? Yeah, encapsulation, polymorphism,
uh-huh,
abstraction, inheritance. Okay. These are the four pillars of the OOPS concepts.
Uh-huh.
These are the four pillars of the OOPS concepts.
Okay.
Simply we can say, without OOPS concept, there is no technology, yes or no?
Yep.
Without OOPS concepts, what is that? There is no technology in the market.
Okay.
Got it? Why? Because if you go for any technology, basics are OOPS concepts.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Same way, there are six pillars of the SharePoint. What are they? There are six pillars of the SharePoint.
Okay.
What are they? One is sites.
Uh-huh.
Communities, content, search, insight. What is that? Insight, composites.
Okay.
Okay, clear, Vinda?
Okay.
What are all the six pillars of the SharePoint?
Sites, communities, content, search, insight, and composites.
Yes, one is sites, communities, content, search, insight, and composites.
Okay.
Okay, got it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, clear?
Okay.
Yeah, first thing is sites.
Uh-huh.
What is the sites? Remember this architecture, very, very important.
Uh-huh.
Okay, till you are there with SharePoint.
Okay.
Very, very, very important. Okay, what is the web application? Already I told you. Collection of site collection.
Uh-huh.
What is the site collection? Collection of website. What is the website or subsite? Collection of pages or web pages.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, first thing is sites. In the sites, what is the web application? Collection of site collection. What is the site collection? Collection of website or subsite. What is the website or subsite? Collection of
pages.
What is that?
Pages.
Pages.
Uh-huh.
Okay, got it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Next, this we can call it as sites. This architecture we will call it as sites.
Okay.
Okay, for example, web application means, I can say, http://tcs.com. Okay, what are all the site collections? In TCS, we have many site collections, yes or no? HR, sales,
mm-hmm,
okay, finance, marketing, Okay, IT. Mm-hmm. These are what? Site collections.
Site collections, okay.
Okay. So here, how HR people can access this site? http://tcs.com/HR. How salespeople will access this site? tcs.com/sales. Mm-hmm. How mm-hmm. finance people will access this site? tcs.com/finance. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. If HR people, they cannot access the content of sales and finance.
Mm-hmm.
Sales people, they cannot access the content of what?
HR.
Got it? Finance mm-hmm. people, they cannot access the content of sales and HR.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, got it? Any doubt?
No.
Yeah, this we can call it as what? Sites. Okay, mm-hmm. what is the sites? What is the sites? So, web application is the main thing.
Mm-hmm.
Web application is the root level in SharePoint. What is the web application? Collection of site collections.
Site collections.
Collection? Collection of website or subsite. What is the website or subsite? Collection of?
Pages.
Web pages. Mm-hmm. Got it? That mm-hmm. is one pillar of the SharePoint. That is what?
Sites. Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Sites.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What is the next pillar of the SharePoint?
Content.
Yeah, content. No.
Communities.
Okay, what is the community generally? Community.
Mm-hmm.
You know Facebook, right? Don't
yeah.
say I only have Facebook account.
Yeah, yeah,
why?
Yeah.
Because, yeah, even 5th class standard people also maintaining the Facebook accounts, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. In Facebook, we will create the community. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We can create the community and we can add 10 members, colleagues into that community. Assume
mm-hmm.
that.
Mm-hmm.
We can add many. There is no restriction. Assume that we have 10 members added into that community. In
mm-hmm.
that community, if we post any query,
mm-hmm.
if we post any query, that query can be visible to all 10 members of that community and they can respond for that query. Yes or
okay.
no?
Right.
Only these 10 people can share the data. Yes or no?
Uh-huh. Right.
Same kind of functionality Microsoft has implemented in SharePoint.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Now tell me, what is the community? Communities are centralized location where we can share the data or knowledge. Got it? What is the community? Communities are centralized location where we can share the data or knowledge.
Okay.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Any doubt? Assume that where I have posted one query. What is that query name? What is the SharePoint? What is the SharePoint? Some people may respond that SharePoint is what? Collaboration portal. Some mm-hmm. other people may respond that SharePoint is what? Content management system. Some mm-hmm. other people may respond that SharePoint is what? Document management system. Got
mm-hmm.
it?
Mm-hmm.
All three definitions came into the picture. Now mm-hmm. onwards, if you go for any interview, if they ask what is the SharePoint means, you should tell like this. What is the SharePoint? SharePoint is what?
Collaboration portal.
SharePoint is collaboration portal. Mm-hmm. All these three responses can be visible to all the members of what?
Community.
Community. Yes or no?
Yep.
Yeah. Next, what is the SharePoint? SharePoint is? What is that?
Content
system. Mm-hmm. What is the SharePoint? SharePoint is what? Document management
systems.
Clear? Any doubt?
No.
Yeah. So this is called, what is that? Communities. So what is the communities? Communities are centralized location where we can share the data or knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
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 Yeah.
Now tell me, what is the SharePoint? Note it down. SharePoint mm-hmm. is the collaboration portal.
Mm-hmm.
Note it down. SharePoint is collaboration portal
uh-huh.
where we can share the data.
Okay.
Where we can share the data along with global or internal users based on business requirement is called SharePoint.
Okay.
Okay, this is not my definition, this is Microsoft definition. Please
okay.
note it down. What is a SharePoint? SharePoint is the collaboration portal where
data.
You can share the data along with global or internal users based on business requirement is called SharePoint.
Okay.
Okay, clear?
Yeah.
Why should we go for SharePoint?
Because it's all centralized.
Yeah, it is centralized. Okay, wonderful.
And it automatically hosted.
Okay, very good. Great. Next. Why? Because mainly people are looking for cost cutting. Nowadays, every client they are looking for what? Always reducing the budget cost, project cost. Okay. Assume that there is a, I need to develop one application for TCS.com. What is that? TCS.com. Okay. If we go for .NET for this requirement, in TCS we have again many departments. Yes or no? What are they? IT, sales, finance, marketing and HR. Okay, we need to develop this separate application for IT, separate application for sales, finance, marketing and HR. Okay, to achieve this requirement, at least the budget cost will go around 10 crores. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Even it will take lot of time to develop this many application in .NET. We need to hire many .NET resources. One lead, one project manager, project lead, on-site coordinator, analysis and the designer, so many people are required. Okay, and it will take lot of time to deliver this project. If it is taking time, obviously budget cost also would be increased, yes or no?
Yep.
Yeah. Nowadays all US clients they are looking for what? Always reducing the project cost. Got it? Same kind of requirement, we can deliver the project within 3 months. Around only 10 lakhs. Okay, that is the trend now. That's why entire market is looking for SharePoint. That's why SharePoint got quite that much demand in the market. Okay, got it?
Yeah.
Next, this is about what? SharePoint. Okay, next, what is the next pillar of the SharePoint? Sites, communities, content.
Content.
Yeah. What is the content? Any idea?
What is the content? What's in what? What is? I don't know. Tell me.
Content. Content. Yeah. Content means see. SharePoint tightly integrated with what? SQL Server.
Okay.
Just I am repeating. SharePoint tightly integrated with what?
SQL Server.
SQL Server. Without SQL Server, there is no SharePoint. Simply I can say, without SQL Server, there is no SharePoint. See? This is what? SharePoint Server. This is what? SQL Server.
SQL Server.
Okay, all SharePoint content would be stored under where? SQL Server.
SQL Server, okay.
Okay, backbone of the SharePoint is? What? IIS.
IIS.
Heart of the SharePoint is? SQL Server. Got it. If somebody comes to you and asking about that, can we install the SharePoint by using Oracle database? What is your answer?
No.
No, we cannot. Why? We cannot say anything. Why? Because these are all business tactics. Why? Because if you want to implement the SharePoint, the user 100% they should purchase what is that?
SQL Server.
Why? SharePoint is Microsoft product. SQL Server also what? Microsoft product.
Correct.
Okay, if you want to implement, Microsoft will get dual benefit. Yes or no?
Yep.
Got it? If you purchase SharePoint product, automatically you will purchase SQL Server also. They are right.
Yep.
Yeah, any doubt? No. So here, whatever you are uploading the data or document, all this data would be stored under where? In SQL Server. Yeah. if you are storing something in SQL Server, obviously it is very, 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 very secure. Got it? Okay, any doubt?
No.
Yeah, great. This is about what? Content.
Content.
Okay, next, what is the next pillar of the SharePoint?
Search.
Yeah, search. What is the search? Any idea? Generally, always you people are using the Google search, right? Always you people are using the what?
Google search.
There is no difference between Google search and our SharePoint search. Okay? In Google, we can search the content whatever we require throughout globally. Yes or no?
Yep.
We can search the content whatever we require throughout globally. Mm-hmm. Okay? Yeah. Whereas coming to the SharePoint, we can search the content whatever we require what? Within the SharePoint application.
SharePoint. Okay.
Got it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Any doubt?
No.
Yeah. Search is one basic pillar of the SharePoint and a wonderful functionality, and there is no difference between Google search and our SharePoint search. In Google, we can search the content whatever we require throughout globally.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas in SharePoint, we can search the content whatever existing within the SharePoint application.
Okay.
Okay. Clear, Vinda?
Uh-huh.
Suppose, assume that TCS.com. In TCS, around 3 lakhs employees are working, yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
When you join to the TCS, immediately what you are looking for? Documents, yes or no?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Anyone joined to the company, always they are looking for what? Documents.
Mm-hmm.
Open the TCS portal, when you search SharePoint admin documents, then admin documents should be displayed like a Google search. Then mm-hmm. required document you can open and you can go through it, yes or no?
Yep.
Actually, where they are storing the documents, we don't know. We mm-hmm. cannot navigate also. Simply mm-hmm. we can use Google search. Like a Google search, same kind of functionality Microsoft has implemented in SharePoint.
SharePoint. Okay.
Got it. Mm-hmm. Next, what else?
Insight.
Yeah, insight. What is the insight? Innovation. Insight means new things.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? See, I told you, SharePoint tightly integrated with SQL Server.
Mm-hmm.
If it is only SQL Server, what about rest of the databases? Got it?
Mm-hmm.
See, SharePoint tightly integrated with SQL Server. Right. Assume that I have some data in Oracle.
Mm-hmm.
Now I would like to present the data in my SharePoint application. Is it possible? Yes. Mm-hmm. SharePoint not only integrated with SQL Server, we mm-hmm. can also pull the data from different data sources. Might be Oracle or SAP or reports or whatever it may be. Getting me in the?
Okay.
Okay. SharePoint not only integrated with SQL Server, we can also integrate it with any third-party database, then we can pull that data. Pull that data means like information, reports, graphs, mm-hmm. pie charts, cubes, everything. Clear?
Okay.
Yeah. Any doubt?
No.
Yeah. Next, what is the next pillar of the SharePoint?
Composites.
Yeah, composites. Now tell me, what is the composites, last pillar of the SharePoint? Composites means SharePoint related components is called composites.
Okay.
Okay. So assume that you want to develop on SharePoint application. Okay. What we need to do, we need Visual Studio, SharePoint Designer, Design Manager, Reporting Designer, got it? These are the things are required. These are all we can call it as what? Composites. What does it mean? We can deliver the SharePoint project as much as possible by providing rich graphical user interface, by providing what? More security levels. Got it?
Okay.
That we can call it as what? Composites.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now tell me, what are all the six pillars of the SharePoint? Sites, communities, content, search, insight, composites.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Got it?
Yeah.
Till then, go through it. Okay. Tomorrow, I will uh-huh. give you depth of the SharePoint. Okay. If I give you entire information single day, you will be confused on it. I know.
Okay.
Okay, so tomorrow I will tell you how to install the SharePoint. To install the SharePoint, what are the prerequisites are required? Okay, next, what are the hardware and software requirements for SharePoint? And what are the difference between different version of the SharePoint in market?
Okay.
I will teach you these concepts. Today, I have completed what is the IaaS. Next, basic concepts of the IaaS. And why should we go for SharePoint? What is the SharePoint? What are the six pillars of the SharePoint? These are the things I covered. Got it?
Okay.
Any question for today's session, Vrinda?
No, not. I'll just review all this, and then if there's anything I still not clear, I'll check with your next class.
Yeah, okay. Actually, this class is recorded.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Maybe you will receive after this session. Go through it. Still, if you have any question, any confusion, you can tell me. Okay?
Okay.
In our session, I will clarify, then we will move forward to next class.
Okay.
Okay, clear, Rinda?
Mm-hmm. And we will be using SharePoint 2013, right?
Yes, I am always telling latest version 2013.
Okay.
Why? Because already 2016 is there in the market. Next year, they are going to launch.
Mm-hmm.
So still, I am only teaching only latest version. No need to.
Okay. And generally, how is the market? Is it like a lot of people are using SharePoint 2013, or do they still use the older versions?
No. A lot of people nowadays are using latest version.
Latest. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. 2013. It is a very good product in the market. Always all the people are using 2013.
Yeah, even my office, they're planning to shift everything to SharePoint.
Yes, exactly. That's why. Okay. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Vrinda. Tomorrow I'll meet.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Okay, thank you.
Good night. Bye.
Good night.